Træeren.
Vi har midlertidigt forladt Træerstudiet og Jesper Ekeroth, og det har vi, fordi vi nu skal i gang med magasinprogrammet Bognyt her i Træeren på Feedback. I slutningen af sidste måned var jeg, mit navn det er Peter Ryhmer, og så Stig Ultima fra Martin Mortensen Boghandlen, Køgevej i Torstrup. Ja, vi var til bogmesse i Forum. Her var vi så heldige at få et interview med Colin Dexter, manden som har skabt Inspector Morse fra Oxford. Colin Dexter, han bor selv i Oxford og har igennem mange år undervist på universitetet. Siden 1988 har forfatteren været fuldtidsbeskæftiget som forfatter, og indtil dags dato har han skrevet 11 Morse-romaner, Morse-kriminalromaner. Heraf er de 8 oversat til dansk. Velkommen til Bognyt og interview med Colin Dexter.
Colin Dexter, one of the most famous crime writers in the world. Welcome here to our radio program.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I'm loving it here. Could I just mention one thing that I don't feel at all satisfactory about Copenhagen? And that is that they fill all the schnapps up right to the top, don't they? But if you go into a pub and you buy lager, they only fill it about half or two-thirds full. And I do think that this is a terribly sad thing for a man like me from England. But apart from that, I've enjoyed it very much.
Yeah, that's something we all think. They are giving too little when we are coming on a pub. They must have a bigger, larger glass or
indeed,
something like that.
Indeed, yes.
You have written a lot of books.
Not really. I've never been a full-time writer. No. I couldn't have done that. I spent all my life in education. I was a school teacher for 13 years, and then I worked for the University of Oxford for 22 years, and then I finished 4 years ago. But I've never been a full-time writer, so I've not written all that much at all, really.
What inspired you to be a writer? When did you start writing books?
I've never been inspired in my life at all. No. I wrote one or two books when I was a school teacher. And then one very wet weekend in North Wales. Do you know North Wales?
Yes, I know North Wales.
Well, it's not unknown for it to rain in North Wales. And I was sitting there one Saturday afternoon with my children, and they said to me, why didn't I take them to a place where the sun was shining? Like everybody else's father. And we were all miserable and wanted to go home, and I had nothing to do, and I'd read all the lousy books that were in the place. And that's when I first, 20-odd years ago, just a little more than 20 years ago, when I first wrote the first sentence about Inspector Morse.
Inspector Morse, yes, he's become very, very famous indeed because of television, probably most, but also because of it's a good books. It's very good books.
Yes, I'm very glad you mentioned that. I mean, it's all very well, this telelark, but I'm very glad you mentioned there were some books as well, because, you know, sometimes people think that this telly is all that matters. But I think for a lot of us, and a lot of people here, obviously, today, a unique thing about a book, isn't there? You know, if you've got a book, you know, even if you went on holiday with Brigitte Bardot, you'd perhaps say, I'll take a book as well, so that you could read it occasionally. Don't you think so?
Yes, we think so.
You've heard
also
of Brigitte Bardot, haven't you? I mean, no, you haven't.
No.
You haven't? Of course you have. All your listeners have heard of Brigitte Bardot. She was the most gorgeous girl that was ever on the films.
Uh-huh. Now we are talking about films and so on, compared to books. Do you think it's good to have television to make pictures out of books? Do you think that's a good idea, or do you think books should stand alone?
No, I say yes to everything, but I think that they're very different mediums, aren't they? If you're on the television, all you've got is dialogue and photography to tell the story, that's all. If you're in a book, you can dip into the third person, you can describe and do whatever you like. And I think there are very real differences between the two mediums. And I think you've got to accept this. For example, it's extremely difficult on the television to make Inspector Morse particularly clever. Very difficult, because you can't sit him there in the middle of the screen and say, Morse is thinking. You can't do that. But you can do that in a book. And so there are shortcut literary clues you can't do very well. On the other hand, of course, you can take pictures, you can photograph a very beautiful city like Oxford.
Eve.
to træer hver søndag.
But books sells better when it had been in the telly. Isn't that true?
In the books on the...
Yeah, they sell better. Sell better.
Sell better afterward. Yeah. Oh, I think so. Obviously, there are not all that many people who read these days anyway. But as soon as something does go on the television, I think people are conscious of your name. And obviously, you get tie-ins, don't you, in the bookshops, television tie-in. And yes, this has helped. And certainly, I've become very much better known since the television. All I was suggesting was there is this unique thing about books. And quite a lot of people read me before the television started. I mean, that's why they wanted to do them on the television. And of course, sometimes the opposite in an odd sort of way happens. You get something on the television that is done from a book, and it's a lousy television program, and nobody buys the books. I don't think it's automatic, if you see what I mean, that once you're on television, your book sales go up. Sometimes the opposite happens. But with me, I was very fortunate. I've been a lucky man all my life. Anyway.
Are you satisfied about the TV production of Inspector Morse? Do you think they're doing it well enough, or what is your opinion about it?
Well, I think I've been, again, very fortunate. I think they've done it very, very well. And I was very lucky, of course, I suppose, with John Thor as the major character, because he's very much like Morse in a way, rather sad and miserable and melancholy old boy. And I think John Thor and the professionalism of him and Kevin Whately made an enormous difference to the success of the television.
Is there anything you think about? I heard is there two television shows back, or two books, or what is it? They're almost finished with the TV series.
Yes. I think that we have had 7 series in England. We've had 28 to our films. Now, that's quite a lot. And I think all of us felt it was about time that we stopped. But they are going to do John Thor and Kevin Whately, Sergeant Lewis and Inspector Morse, are going to do a couple more, not a couple more series, just a couple more programs. And they're going to do that, I hope, next year. They will be one-offs, as we would call them. Is that right, you know, for Christmas? So we haven't quite finished with the old boy yet, and that will take it up to 32-hour things, which I think is enough for anybody, really, I think.
But you're not stopping writing books about him, or you're still continuing writing about him?
I get older all the time, and I find it more and more difficult, I think, to sit down and write. I get asked out so much, you know, to places like Copenhagen and so on all the time. But I promise that I will try to write a couple more full-length Inspector Morse books. And in fact, just out now is a book of short stories, which I've read, some of which are about the old boy Morse. But I can't see myself writing all that much more. I think I'm getting worse and older all the time.
When do you stop writing?
Well, I think that... I shall probably always be writing a little bit, but there are so many things to do in life, aren't there, you know? Like washing up the pots and mowing the lawn. I mean, all these things are awfully important, aren't they? And I shall probably spend more time, on the things... Well, you will read other people's books, listen to more music and so on.
Is there any other people, any other authors you are inspired by? Is there someone you like especially you would
mention? In the past or in the present?
No, in the present.
Well, I think in England, I think there are some wonderful crime writers. I think of the people writing in England at the minute, most of us would put Ruth Rendell top, I think. She's an extraordinarily imaginative and prolific writer. And I think most crime writers regard her, as it were, the writer's writer, you know. I would put her top, but there are many, many other... people are really in the top bracket in England at the moment writing crime.
I think about an older creamy writer. She's dead now. Her name is Agatha Christie. What is your opinion about Agatha Christie's books?
Oh, I think that she probably had more influence on me than anybody, because I write whodunits, you know, where really what you do is to dangle all the suspects in front of the reader in such a way that you invariably guess the wrong crook. And I think that she could do this marvellously well. This is whodunits, isn't it? Where the emphasis is upon the puzzle. Whodunits, isn't it? Where the emphasis is upon the puzzle and the mystification. And Agatha Christie, I think, well, she wrote an awful lot. She wrote about, what, 85 books. And I think that certainly if you took the top 20 whodunit books of all time, I would have thought she would go off with 5 or 6. I think so. An enormously influential woman in so many ways.
We were talking about maybe stop writing or stop writing Morse books, but have you talked thought about writing books with another person, you know, another character,
detective.
Another detective, or go to another kind of literature, writing genre. Romance or memories or something like that?
No, I don't think so. The only thing I would be wonderfully good at is writing pornography, but nobody wants. You know, it's so bad that I feel that I would be a brilliant man at that, but nobody wants me to do it. They want me to write Morse all the time. But no, I shan't write any more detective stories when Morse is finished. Certainly not, no. I've done very well. We've had enough. We've had a good time. But I think that I wouldn't mind. I've always thought I would like to write one or two literary crit sort of books about the poets. But I don't know. I haven't got the patience all the time these days. But I would like to do that above all, I think, just one serious work on one of my favorite poets. I wouldn't mind that.
Mm. Yeah, at last, when we are finishing the show, I would like to ask you, what is your plans for the future? We have been into it a little bit, but what is your plans for the future? Have you thought about retiring?
I am retired.
Yeah.
I finished with Oxford University 4 years ago, and so there's nothing on there. But when you say about the future, I've been away in England for the last 3 weeks. And I've been in Copenhagen for 4 days, and when I go back, I'm all over England for another 3 weeks on promotion. It's my own fault, the last book I've written. So I should have been away from home for about 6 weeks, literally, all the time. And I shall look forward very much to Christmas. I don't like Christmas anyway. I like Morse. I hate Christmas, but...
Why?
Why? Well, I have no religious faith at all, and I haven't got enough imagination to know what presents to buy anybody. And it seems to me that all the presents we buy are all useless, really, aren't they? You know, you say, oh, how nice to have such a lovely present. The only time Christmas was good was when you bought toys, like trains and aeroplane kits and that sort of thing. But then when you get older, they buy you socks, don't they, and shirts, and I mean, it is really terribly uninteresting, isn't it? So I get fed up with Christmas. I'm always very glad when it's over. Yeah.
Are you a rich man?
Well, I mean, that's a comparative term, isn't it? I've certainly earned a good deal more money since, as you were saying earlier, my books went on the television. Yeah. Although it takes quite a long time to come through, yeah. Yes, I've earned quite a lot of money out of Inspector Morse, so I should be very sad to see him go, really. I'm not terribly anxious to earn too much more.
Do you have two cars?
No, I've just got one car, and I'm thinking of giving that up altogether because I don't like cars. My father was a taxi driver, and I always hated cars when I was a boy. You know how it is, you go against your father, so... I don't think I know the difference between any cars at all, and I have no anxiety at all to have a Rolls Royce or something, or a Merc, no.
Thank you very much for your interview, and you have given us time.
Thank you for your interest.
1, 2, 3'eren hver søndag.
Det var Stig Ultima fra Martin Mortensen, boghandlen Køgevej i Tostrup, og Peter Ryhmer, der interviewede. Om 14 dage en ny omgang Bognyt her på stationen, hvor du kan høre et interview med børnebogsforfatteren Tøger Birkeland. Men det er altså først om 14 dage her på stationen her på Feedback i programmet 3'eren. Lige nu skal vi tilbage til Jesper Ekeroth i 3'er-studiet.